Well, I believe we're live. Hello, greetings, and welcome to the Neverwinter Adventure Hour. I'm your host, Achromatic, and with me today is another one of the genius minds behind the game we all love, Neverwinter. Why don't you introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about who you are and how you make Neverwinter so.
I am Michael Edwards. I am the enemy designer for Neverwinter. I design all of the enemies, bosses, the encounters that the players have fun with and hopefully, you know, beat up and don't cry about.
That's always a good goal. There are no tears in MMOs, as I like to say. So yes, this is it. This is Tiamat. We've assembled our forces. As you can see, we've amassed quite an army here, and we've got devs, we've got players. It is much like the title of this stream says, it is Neverwinter versus Tiamat. We've got friends from all over. I'm gonna adjust the camera here just a little bit. All right, and we've got people from all over the globe, you know, devs, players, you know, PvPers, PvEers alike, and we're all in the Well of Dragons, a new area to Neverwinter, where the Cult of the Dragon is up to something awful, and we're fighting Tiamat. Oh man, you know, this is the moment we've all been waiting for ever since Tyranny of Dragons. You know, the Cult of the Dragon, their whole deal has been to summon Tiamat. So this is it. So tell us a little bit about you know, what was it like working on this? Something I like to ask is, what was the hardest part about designing this battle?
The hardest part about designing the Tiamat fight was making sure all players and all character classes had something to do. You're fighting this giant five-headed dragon that just being near will kill you. So things like taunting doesn't work against Tiamat. She really doesn't care what you have to say about her. So she's just going to wreck you. So trying to find mechanics throughout the fight that let everybody do their part, whether you be a controller, a guardian fighter, a cleric, DPS, everybody has a role to play in this fight, and hopefully they enjoy doing that. Granted, during the phases, your role will change. So whenever you're up actually fighting Tiamat, the guardian fighter is not going to be taunting her. They have different phases where they have to taunt stuff. So things like that, just it was real fun just trying to figure out ways that everybody felt involved with this fight.
Nice. No, I'm very glad. You know, quite often, you know, a lot of feedback people will say is like, oh, you know, this certain class doesn't really mesh well with doing this specific thing in Neverwinter. So it's really great to hear that, you know, all classes are being considered in designing this. You know, and actually, I believe Tiamat is one of the biggest bosses you all have ever designed, like just physically the largest.
She is our largest animated enemy.
Did that prove any complications in sort of designing the encounter?
It was from an art and tech standpoint, it was difficult just trying to get something that large to look good and still perform well. From a design standpoint, just trying to get a way that players could fight her and still feel like it was an important fight. Like early on, we had it where you'd go up to Tiamat and you'd start fighting her, and you're about the size of her toenail. So half the fight, you had melee guys beating on a toenail. That didn't feel very good. So just trying to figure out ways to make sure players had moments where they saw Tiamat in all of her glory, and then when they're actually fighting Tiamat, actually being face-to-face with her. It was a lot of fun challenges. We have a door.
We have a door. Let's sparkly. Oh, there we go. All right, just had to aim it right, folks. Yeah. Those doors can be tricky. Those tricky Neverwinter doors. All right, and it looks like people are getting in, so that's good to hear. We wouldn't want a wonky door to aid Tiamat in her takeover of Toril. So now it looks like we're seeing a few different summoners. Now, we're not fighting Tiamat outright,
Not yet. At the start of this, you are entering the end of the summoning. You have the Red Wizards are working with the Cult of the Dragon to summon Tiamat from the Nine Hells. Rothmodar, as you've seen in previous campaign modules, is here. He's helping out. And this is, each one is representing a different dragon head trying to pull Tiamat from the Nine Hells to help out and take over the world. So that is what this is, and you're just trying to stop them. They have the power, though, to help you defeat Tiamat. So whenever a summoner is defeated, you might need to worry about what this thing is you see on the screen here, where the soul of a dragon is encased in a gem. So you can use that in the fight against Tiamat to protect your party.
Oh, cool! I did not know that. Yeah, it was kind of interesting. So we had kind of a little you could call it a taste of Tiamat during our Extra Life live stream. We checked it out on the promo shard, and of course I just had my character, and I was just running around, you know, using the insta kill command. I didn't pick up on any of those gems, so that's really cool. I did not know about that. Very cool. So now I imagine, are there these different colors? Do they provide different buffs, or
they all react differently to the different breath weapon they represent? So like I believe we have the green dragon gem there, and that will clear out and protect players from the green dragon's poison breath. So whenever he breathes poison down, he leaves this field of poison that the players either just sit in and die, or they can use this to clear out an area and push away the poison and have a safe zone inside of this cloud.
Oh, very cool.
So when each gem reacts differently, you have, like, the white dragon. He will freeze everybody and leave a patch of slick ice on the ground. Mm-hmm. If you use the white dragon gem, then it will clear out the ice patch and free anyone from their block of ice if they've been frozen.
Ah, very cool. So it's kind of it gives multiple classes a way to sort of act in a support role.
It lets everybody help their team.
Very cool.
And anybody else's team.
Nice.
So here we have Linu has brought several Sehanite clerics from Evreska to help push Tiamat back. So they are right now trying to get aid to banish Tiamat back into the Nine Hells. So, unfortunately, the spell takes a while to cast. They're channeling up the power, but devils are coming from the Nine Hells to try to stop them.
I see.
So, the players have to protect the clerics while they finish their summoning.
Oh, interesting. Now, Tiamat is from the Nine Hells, and I believe, actually, I want to say I saw somewhere that she's from the fourth circle. I felt like I saw a map once, and I'm pretty sure she's from the fourth circle, which I don't know. That's just a bit of weird anecdote.
I'm sure any circle of hell is not the nicest place to be in.
Very true. Very true. Nice to visit. Wouldn't want to live there.
Probably.
Yeah. Oh, it looks like we've got quite a few viewers. So I should probably mention this now that we're busy protecting clerics. So for every 500 viewers we get, we'll be giving out a Scourge Warlock booster pack. And in addition to that, if we manage to hit 2,000 viewers, we'll also be releasing a code for a Fate Spinner title. And that actually not only gives you the title, but it also gives you a Neverwinter Vanguard pack that's filled with tons of cool items that definitely come in useful, whether you're, you know, working through on your max level 18 gear score character, or if you're starting a so definitely something to get excited about. And tell your friends, tell your grandma, tell her to crank up the old dial-up modem and join us here on Twitch or get in zone chat. Yeah. When we see zone chat fill up with people telling other people to come to the live stream, it makes me very happy. It makes me feel loved that you all would spam for us. Looks like Tiamat is here. Wow. Or at least the clerics. Well, there she is. Wow. Looks like the clerics are casting the spell, or I think
they're channeling up. They should be full if they can get the doubles off these last couple?
Yeah.
There we go.
Awesome! Take that. So...
T-Mat doesn't go down easy. She wants a piece.
Okay.
But she's weakened now, so the players have a chance. Before, if you got near Tiamat while she was out further from the Nine Hells, you would just die. Just her presence would kill you. But now players have a chance. Fight back. So we've got... like we're up against the green dragon head.
Mm-hmm. So many effects.
We are working on performance for this, which is part of what this being on preview really is about. It's just making sure that we can get this all running really nice for everyone and fun to play. So it looks like they've taken down the green dragon.
And, oh no, you jumped into the lava! So confession time. I'm actually not the one in the driver's seat today on Neverwinter Adventure. We have our very talented, very awesome systems designer, Chris Gentleman Crush Myers, who's playing Acro, which is the name of the warlock, the Soulbinder warlock actually. So we're super excited to show that off in this epic battle. And yes, it looks like I'm seeing in Twitch chat they're saying Acro loves lava too. That's the during the Extra Life live stream I had a great weapon fighter, and they I'm so used to having not so fast in the R slot, but instead I had Mighty Leap in the R slot. So there were like five times where I just jumped into the lava. It's just
it's probably not safe.
Yep, it's. Yeah, but it was worth it. It was for the kids. So we actually it was amazing. We ended up raising around 27,000.
Fantastic.
Yeah, we actually, you guys, got us on the front page, not only in terms of fundraisers, which are individuals who are raising money for Extra Life, but also top teams. We were up there with Rooster Teeth and Tryon and a few others. It was really impressive. So, you know, to all who donated and all who supported, or you just said nice things or encouraged, just thank you so much for helping us out with that. So back to the fight. It looks like it's a
couch sharing.
What?
Sounds like a couch sharing.
Yes, I guess, well, I you know, don't share accounts unless you're friends with a cryptic dev. That's my advice. But yeah, so it looks like it's a take two for the clerics. Mm-hmm. And so I guess if you die, we had already gotten past this phase, I guess. Can you regress in terms of phases?
So what happens is you have 2 minutes while the clerics are holding Tiamat back to try to push her the rest of the way in. So you have to beat each head back down into the Nine Hells. If you don't, Tiamat comes back, as you see here.
I see.
Now what'll happen is they'll have to fight again, protect the clerics, and get Tiamat back down there so they can try to push the heads back down. Unfortunately, the ones that were defeated will come back. Because they're still part of Tiamat. In fact, they've regained health while in the Nine Hells. So that's part of the strategy of working together as a team, is figuring out how most efficiently to get all those heads shoved back into hell within the time limit.
Let's see. Oh, wow. That's tricky.
It's a little tricky.
Yeah. Oh, I like that. Of course, that means I have to, like, work with other people. But
you have to work with other people. This is very much dependent on everybody in the zone communicating, working together, knowing when to split up, knowing when to come back together. And some of that's just, you know, for the players to figure out. Some of it we tell them, you know, through use of the items, like the soul gems that you get from the dragons. They actually describe that they will help you with the breath weapon, and kind of got to use it to see what it does.
Makes perfect sense. Wow, I didn't know that... That's really cool. Sorry, blowing my mind here. Oh yeah. So sounds like someone was asking in chat, is this the new Paragon path we're using here with this Warlock? And that is correct. This is the Soulbinder path, which works around collecting soul sparks and then using those soul sparks to empower their spells. Oh my, what a red screen. And so in using those soul sparks, they're able to either modify or just cast more powerful versions of their spells. And then combining that with the curse mechanic will lead to some very interesting builds, I feel. Gotten to play around with the Soulbinder much?
Or? I've played a bit with the Soulbinder. Super fun.
Oh, yeah?
I like the Soul Spark mechanic. It's a whole lot of fun to use. Knowing when to use certain powers to consume the sparks is really nice. Super powerful. I love the Warlock, and this is probably my favorite Paragon path we've done so far. Mm-hmm. It comes complete. New UI to support all this.
Oh, wow.
So whenever you're in combat, you'll actually see the resource of the Soul Sparks next to your character building up and getting consumed. It's a lot of new stuff we're doing for this new Paragon path, and we're really happy with where it's going.
Yeah, no, I just in the short time that I had to play around with it, I was doing a lot of damage and I wasn't dying. So you've got my thumbs up. And so it looks like we have 500 viewers, which means we're going to give out our first Scourge Warlock booster pack. Now, what we do normally here on the Neverwinter Adventure Hour is we have a special code word that people enter in, and they can pull from those people who've entered in that code word. And since we have, since you're new to the live stream, I figure, what should our code word be?
Tiamat sounds easy.
Hot diggity dragonborn. The code word is Tiamat. Hashtag Tiamat. All right. Get it in, folks. Hashtag Tiamat. And enter it in, and you will have a chance to win a Scourge Warlock booster pack. And it looks like we've just felled the black dragon head, I think. Looks like it. Awesome. So, which out of the five dragons of Tiamat, which is your favorite?
As part of Tiamat or dragons in general?
I would say, well, both, actually. Yeah.
I think both would probably be blue.
Blue! Interesting. I have recently learned to... I was kind of neutral on blues, and then I actually wrote a lore blog, a blog about just blue dragons, and they're really cool. They're vain and live near the beach, and I'm like, oh man, that's so cool. But yes, what about blue dragons excites you?
I like the electricity. Mm-hmm. I just think that's a really neat element to be throwing around at people. I like this in the Tiamat fight. The blue dragon actually has the ability, whenever it hits players with its breath weapon, it can actually cause that lightning to chain to another player, which will kill lightning. Both players.
Like instantly?
Yes.
What?
It can do heavy damage. Most of the time it'll kill you if you're not well geared. If you have a blue dragon soul, you can actually drop a icon that will attract that lightning, which will save you, like a lightning rod.
Like a lightning rod. Very cool. Oh, that's awesome. So, I guess, I see we're back to the cleric phase. Yeah. So I'm curious, the phases in this boss battle, was that, what was the design intention behind that? Was that lore-based, or, why not just charge at Tiamat?
Well, part of it was, when you start off and you're facing the summoners, it's telling the story of really what's going on, that they are actually summoning Tiamat. She's not there yet. You also get to see what the fate of Rathmadar and Severin is. Mm-hmm. So those are characters that you've already seen in previous modules.
Absolutely.
So you get to find out what happens to those guys, and then during the fight, we go back and forth between these two phases. Part of it's to let players do their role, so someone that does control while fighting one of the dragon heads isn't as useful in that phase, but you probably need them for the phase where you're defending the clerics. That way, the controller and the tanks can actually get all the aggro off of the clerics. Then it's also just kind of getting an ebb and flow to the fight. If it's just all out 15, 20 minutes of heavy fight, it's a little too stressful. Makes my heart flutter. I don't like that. So we kind of let it calm down a little bit. So that's really why we kind of like that. And it feels pretty good going back and forth with that flow. Mm-hmm. So far, we've really liked it.
Cool. Yeah, no, I think definitely the time limit is... oh, man, time limits. Just watching that clock countdown, just... I don't know, like... I don't know if I'm looking more at the... more at the dragon heads or at the clock. Like, it's... Yeah, I gotta say, you've... yeah.
Well, right now they've got to get all of these dragon heads down in just a couple more minutes.
Oh, snap.
So, I think they can do it.
Yes.
I can fix that. I'll just raise everything's health triple, maybe quadruple. That'll be okay, right?
I guess we'll find out. If it's too easy, we definitely want to challenge our players. So I think it's time for us to give out a prize in these final seconds of this battle. So let's find out. Get those hashtag Tiamats in there, and
ooh, just barely. They almost had it done.
Oh,
Tiamat came back.
So close.
I love the gelatinous cube. Such a good mount.
Jelly cube. Winner is Flag the Reaper. That's an interesting name. Congratulations, Flag the Reaper. You have won, my friend, a Scourge Warlock booster pack. Congratulations, you should be very happy. All your friends will be totally jealous when you strut down the Streets of Protectors Enclave with your Irinius of Belials at your side and tons of cool stuff. I believe there are some really awesome enchants in there. Get excited. All right, so it looks like were we not successful in our Tiamat endeavor?
Tiamat one.
This time.
We are still working on the cutscenes, rewards, all that. So.
Okay, so there will
right
be.
Right now, it just ended, but it will be a lot cooler.
So there will be a little more. I guess, a little more the theatricality
yes.
to the battle. Okay, cool.
And an explanation of why everybody didn't die because Tiamat got out. All of that is coming.
That's, you know, it's funny. I hadn't thought of that, but that you make an excellent point, and that if Tiamat escapes, I imagine she'd probably want to wreak some havoc on the denizens of, I'd say the Sword Coast, but the Well of Dragons is not on the Sword Coast, if I'm mistaken.
No.
Yeah, my geography of Toril is failing me. This is usually the point where one of the players corrects me, but you know what? It's all good. Speaking of balancing of the content, a lot of people have been wondering whether or not, just because players have become super powerful, And they're only going to get more powerful. We've got some amazing new gear coming with the module. Just will older content maybe, will there be like, you know, we have an epic mode, will there be like a super duper epic mode or something like that, or has any thought been given to us?
We're always looking at our older dungeons, our what we're doing for newer content, and we are looking into things we can. It's nothing that we've set in stone yet.
Okay.
So nothing we can really talk about, but that is definitely being considered. We want to make sure that our players that are reaching the end of the game have something to do with all that awesome stuff they're getting.
Absolutely. Alright, so it looks like, if memory serves, on the preview server, the fight runs every 30 minutes. However, when it goes live, it will be a little different. It'll be every hour?
It'll be once an hour on the hour.
Oh, okay. All
right. So, yeah, right now we run it on preview every 30 just to get as many people in there as fast as possible.
Absolutely, yeah.
Get as much feedback that we can use to balance it, make it better, polish it up. But, yeah, we'll be on the hour every hour come launch. It will also, at the launch of World of Dragons, it will not be immediately available. We are going to hold it back long enough for players to gear up, get used to the World of Dragons content. We will release.
Interesting. Okay. So so Tiamat will not rise with Rise of Tiamat, it sounds like.
She's just taking her time.
Exactly. I mean, she's a dragon goddess. Nobody needs to force her out of anything. But yeah, we will await with bated breath for Tiamat's entrance. And like, we're getting, people are saying weird things in Twitch chat. So looks like we've got I think somebody asked about the next class. You guys just got the Scourge Warlock. Oh, you guys. I see Elvis has been suggested. That'd be cool. You could have all these like hip dance moves. And like, I don't know, you could gyrate at enemies and, you know.
We might have to raise our ESRB rating.
Okay.
At Elvis like that. We'll have to be careful.
That's very true. But yeah, looks like the crowd is hungry for bards today, which I'm okay with. I purchased the Player's Handbook at Gen Con for 5th edition, and it's a beautiful, beautiful book. And so I've recently made the decision to go for a bard as my first D&D character. That is just I played one in 3.5, and they were good, but I feel like they really took them to the next level. In terms of like being useful. Because I feel like in 3.5 the bard was a class that's nice to have, but not necessarily vital to a party. And in this case, I feel like they can be.
Yeah.
So excited about that.
Like our warlock is not happy with current loadout. I'm going to swap some things around here.
Oh yeah, looks like changes are being made. Awesome. Yeah, I totally tricked out this warlock. For this battle, I figure, you know, if it's Tiamat, you gotta go all out, because it's Tiamat. Yep. And speaking of going all out, we've actually got a very special prize for you. So our friends at WizKids gave us this. Oops, it's the light's kind of reflecting packaging. So our friends at WizKids gave us this really cool attack wing starter set, and it's got tons of really awesome dragons. And I know, totally awesome, right?
Yeah.
So it's definitely something to want, and we need a super cool code word, and I'm gonna let you guys choose that. So it's an attack wing. It's a game played with the dragon minis, and so you actually play as dragons, which is really cool because you don't often get to play as dragons. in just in D&D related in media, and you can fly around and you wreak havoc on other people who are playing as other dragons. It's pretty cool. I fought my friend as a gold. He was a gold dragon and I was a blue dragon, and I was gonna win. Technically it was a stalemate, but I totally would have won.
Oh, of course.
You know, because you know blue dragons, of course.
Yes.
For sure. All right, so I'm seeing a few cool code words. I'm seeing hashtag red hair. So actually, my hair is pink. I know it looks definitely red in this light. It's pink and purple and red and orange and red. I dyed it that way because during Extra Life, I challenged our viewers to get us to 10,000 in that day. And I think within like the next 15 minutes, we hit 10,000. And they got to choose my hair color. And
they couldn't make up their mind.
Well, I heard a lot of pinks, but I also heard a lot of purples, and I heard some oranges, and probably some reds were in there, but chat scrolls really quickly. So, I'm just like, all right, well, I don't want to choose just one, so I just went crazy.
It works?
Yeah. It's, I don't know. It's crazy. But... I'm seeing Dragon Brony, Soul Food, Rainbow Hair of Swag, hashtag Pig Hump, hashtag Son of McD, hashtag Dad Hair though. Let's have something a little more Tiamat related. Hashtag Dev Hair. Hashtag WizKids. Oh, I like that one. Let's do hashtag WizKids. So get it in chat. With the S or a Z. Yes. So hashtag WizKids and get that in chat for a chance to win this really cool attack wing starter set. I'm gonna hold it up once more. I'm gonna hold it up over my face because it's so pretty. And there we go. Yeah. And ta-da. Yeah. The package is very reflective, which is both great because not only will it protect the valuable item, but also if you don't want people to see what you have, so because like obviously if anyone saw this, they would be immediately inclined to liberate you from this wonderful wonderful item. But it's sort of a built-in security measure.
About to hop back in.
All right. Tiamat, take two. Okay. All right. So I guess let's start with the easy one. So we've got two cool questions about what's your favorite class and something about class balancing. What is your favorite class actually?
Right now, my favorite class is Hunter Ranger.
Ah, okay.
I'm playing one of those. Somebody said, hey, these aren't very good. So I said, okay. So I started one, and I play it, and it's my favorite class, and they are pretty okay.
Nice. I'm glad to... I'm glad to hear you're enjoying it. Yeah, I have a level 5 Hunter Ranger. I've been... I don't know. I like my Great Weapon Fighter so much. I just love smashing things, and I have a Scythe Transmutation weapon.
Yep.
I can't say no to a Scythe. There are two things in Neverwinter I can't say no to, and that's a blonde woman with glowing blue eyes, Anara the Cerulean, and a Scythe. And that Scythe also happens to be glowing and blue because of Plague Fire. So I guess maybe it's just glowing blue things I just can't say no to. But I guess my favorite class... I really like my Great Weapon Fighter. I also really like the Scourge Warlock. The Scourge Warlock is a lot of fun. And for soloing, I'm a big fan of the Trickster Rogue. Like, if I just get, like, a nice healer companion on a Trickster Rogue, I found that really effective when I was soloing through Neverwinter back when my main was my Rogue.
Fun.
Yeah.
So we're waiting for people to trickle in.
Yeah.
Now, it is a 25-person fight.
Mm-hmm.
The thing is that we're not going to just say there's only one. So multiple maps get spawned. So as 25 people fill one, we make another. So
oh, nice.
Looks like the first map was filled. Now the second map is probably getting loaded up. Now we've got where we are here, a few more people. Hopefully more people trickle in this one, and we'll have a bigger fight. If not, it's going to be rough.
Good to know. That was another question I was gonna ask. Was that I guess so? There's not just one fight. So it's not like the first come first serve. The first 25 people get to fight, and the rest of the other people are stuck waiting outside. So everybody gets a turn with Tiamat. Well, that's very cool.
So two and a half summoners down.
All right. Oh yeah, looks like
Rathmadar's about to go.
Rathmadar is gone. He has felt the wrath of the Neverwinter community. Oh, I'm getting a look. I'm getting looks. Uh-oh. It's time to give away a prize.
A lot of people shaking their heads.
Prizes make everything better. So, all right, so the winner. There we go. The chatbot was acting up. It's becoming sentient. It's too much. So congratulations to Azriel. I'm just gonna say Azriel. Congrats, Azriel. You have won a WizKids attack wing set. Definitely something to get excited about. Because you actually have three dragons, a red dragon, a gold dragon, and a blue dragon. So not only do you have the chromatics represented, but you also have the metallics. So depending on your alignment, you can play accordingly. And it looks like we've just hit 1,000 views. So we're going to give away another Scourge Warlock booster pack. And for this one, I'm going to choose the code word. And I'm feeling like code word should be protect the clerics. So hashtag protect the clerics, folks. Something you should always do. It's advice to live by, and in this case, it can give you the chance to win a Scourge Warlock booster pack. So enter that in chat, and there it goes. Whoa! Oh man, that is a fast-moving chat. Wow. And it looks like our clerics are almost done with their spells.
Good, they're doing good.
Yeah, they're going strong.
Lots of devils, they don't stand a chance.
Yeah, no, they do not. So actually, I guess on the subject of we were talking about the players getting in. So this is really Neverwinter's first real raid, in a sense.
It's kind of raid, it's kind of heroic encounter-y.
Yeah. There are definitely it's unlike anything we've ever seen in Neverwinter, and that's awesome. So I guess what inspired you all to take this route rather than having just like a lair of Tiamat dungeon?
Well, it's Tiamat.
Mm-hmm.
And if five people could take out Tiamat, not much of a threat to the world.
That's true.
I'm pretty sure that's an okay fight. So we decided we wanted to get a lot of players involved. We wanted to be just players in the world, a little less, coordinated guild raid, and more you are working with your fellow players, just all of you, you have a thing to do. So we decided to go for 25 man, so it's a full group per head. Mm-hmm. During this phase. So how it rolls out, and we're going to see how how the players like it, and hopefully we can do more stuff like this if they like it, and if they don't, we'll fix it. Something else.
Right. Sounds cool. All right, looks like we're attacking the white dragon head with its glowing blue eyes. I have to say the cranial shape of the white dragon is very interesting. It kind of has that little crest, it's a trademark crest, much in the same way that the black dragon has its horns, and the dragon has its little nose lightning rod. Yeah, that is a beautifully rendered white dragon head. Like it's just kind of what it's doing.
It's hanging out. It's about fighting.
It's true, yeah.
Every now and then it bites. Our warlock might have a problem.
Uh-oh. Oh. We make it. Looks like he did. All right. Someone put hashtag kill the clerics. Don't kill the clerics. Looks like we're gonna give players maybe one more minute to enter in hashtag protect the clerics in chat, just because we've actually got a few more people joining us. We're gonna have some time to
back.
Yes, she is. And like you said, with this, there will be some adjustments made to
Oh yeah, definitely. We haven't even started our performance pass.
Oh wow, okay.
We're still doing just main core, how we want the fight to flow, and then get all the performance hopefully working on every machine we can.
Awesome. I'm glad to hear that, because my laptop at home is really, really slow, and it chokes up in Protector's Enclave. And I definitely want to fight Tiamat in the comfort of my own home, or as it's otherwise known as the Acroplex. I think it's time to give away our second Scourge Warlock booster pack of the day. You guys have been so patient and so awesome entering in those code words. There is. Gwout. Rider. Gwout Rider. Congrats to Gwout Rider. Gwout Rider. You guys have the most interesting Twitch names, I gotta say. Points for creativity. Although minus points because they're hard to pronounce sometimes. But only some. I appreciate creativity. And also the challenge of pronouncing some of these names. So it's all good. You guys are great.
So this is a general problem with getting hit by the white dragon head's breath weapon. It freezes you for a really long time.
Yeah.
And that's why if you have that white soul gem, you can pop it for your friends. If you don't, you just make them sad.
Aw.
Don't be sad. Don't be sad, Maker.
Don't make your friends sad. Because the friends that slay together, presumably slay Tiamat, hopefully slay Tiamat, stay together. So, hopefully. Be nice to, especially the clerics. So. It looks like we have defeated, or we're on to the heads now. All right, it looks like they've sustained some damage, so hopefully we'll be able to take them down, and we'll fall, and we'll have proof of it. Proof that Neverwinter is greater than Tiamat. Yeah, it's funny, actually. Speaking of just the name Tiamat, there was a big debate around the office whether it was Tiamat or Tiamat. And so I actually Googled it, and turns out it is Tiamat, because I think it's from some ancient goddess. I think she was either Mesopotamian or Babylonian. But yeah, so the more you know. But yeah, no, it was like a legit discussion of like, how do we pronounce it?
It's understandable. Mm-hmm. I still unfortunately say Tiamat because Hooked on Phonics worked for me.
Oh, there you go.
Looks like Tiamat.
So. No, I mean, I don't know.
That's a reference. Right?
What?
I don't know if they still do that. Dude.
Hooked on Phonics, I don't think, is around in many schools anymore.
I remember Hooked on Phonics. There was an infomercial in the 90s. Fun times, the 90s. Oh wow, so looks like Gandalf 808 is helping us out. Tiamat is a chaos monster, a primordial goddess of the ocean. And it looks like she was the mother of some younger gods and some other people. Let's see, Magus 0002 says she was Babylonian. Or no, now someone's saying Sumerian. Uh-oh. So somebody call a theologist. We've got a debate on our hands. Yes, so class balance. So all of our class balancing changes are available on the Neverwinter forums. We've got specific threads dealing with just the devoted cleric, because the devoted cleric is actually getting a huge makeover as well. And the trickster rogue is also getting quite a bit of work done as well. So we have two threads devoted to those two classes. We also have a thread devoted to some of the other classes. And I believe we also have a thread specifically for the Soulbinder Warlock Paragon Path, and I think some for the artifact gear even as well. And the live stream. But although if you're already here, you probably don't need to go to the forum thread about the live stream. But if you really, really want to, we won't.
I think they're gonna beat it this time.
I think so too.
Sounds like it might be a little too easy. What do y'all think?
I don't know. I think
a little harder?
You just need two Tiamats, or you just need a Tiamat with like 10 heads.
Yeah.
Just you know, put a gray head, a purple head, a brown head, because those are all technically chromatic dragons. And if she is the goddess of chromatic dragons, you know, it works.
Where we got room to squeeze those in.
Yeah, exactly. Just somewhere between the chaos and said Chaotic Turtle 97 says Tiamat is gravy. Cool.
I like gravy.
Great, yeah. Tiamat Gravy's gravy. Good. It's destructively delicious. Roller 300 says crank the heads up to 11. Well, who knows what'll happen if we defeat Tiamat this time. We're doing pretty well, and looks like we're gonna get our second chance to fight those heads. And second, actually, we just gotta lay the smackdown on some devils here. Clerics can do their thing. So, looks like some people are saying at Crystalline Dragons, the Kentucky Fried, hashtag Kentucky Fried Dragon, that's cute. Mm. Five heads are better than one, that's very true. She is Tiamat. And the white dragon head, being a little more active this time. He's fighting rather than just mad dogging us. And, oh, it looks like devils will continue to attack you as you fight the heads.
Yep. Devils will still come. Still trying to figure out if we want to keep that or replace it with something else.
Okay.
What do you think?
Well, I don't know. I mean, it's funny. At first, I thought they were cultists.
Okay.
Like, just cultists who are like, no, stop fighting Tiamat. We worship her. And then I noticed that they all had horns and were flying around and said things like Legion Devil above them, and I'm all like, that's not a cultist. I don't know. But, no, I think Legion, it makes sense. And also, I think it definitely gives you, there's more multitasking going on, which I really enjoy in a boss fight. I don't know. I'm kind of easily distracted, but if I'm distracted enough, I can sort of keep an eye on everything all at once. As these guys will tell you, I get easily distracted. We won! Yes! Oh, the Neverwinter community has teaming up with the devs. We have proved that we are mightier than Tiamat. I am ecstatic. What are the emotions coursing through you at this very moment?
I think I need to make her harder. I'm impressed by the community. I underestimated them, so I think I need to just crank her up to 11.
Yeah.
That's a great idea.
There we go. Tack on a few new heads, you know, give them new breath weapons.
Rocket launchers.
Exactly.
All of it. Making it happen.
Yep. Just, you know, photon torpedoes, you know, some crossover with STO, you know.
I can make it happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get ready, folks.
Good job, guys.
Super Tiamat, Mecha Tiamat.
Yeah.
Robo Tiamat. Oh, man. That'll be great. All right. That was absolutely amazing, folks. I have been moved to give away a Dragonborn Legend pack because I am so astounded and pleased that we all came together and, you know, answered some awesome questions and, you know, defeated this horrible demonic dragon goddess despite her protests. So I think we should give away a Dragonborn Legend pack. Because I like giving away stuff. I'm like Oprah with better hair. So let's see. What should be our? I think our code word is. I've got one. It's moderately clever. Toasty Mott. Because you know she's toast. You know, like Tiamat is toast. Toasty Mott?
Sure.
Is
why
that
not?
Like, or it should have been Toast-a-Mott. Well, it's too late now. It's too late. It's going. Toasty Mott. There we go. All right. Get that in chat, and you will have the chance to win a Dragonborn Legend pack. This is absolutely amazing. I'm just so surprised. This is great. It was very cool. We got to help Elminster too. Oh man. So, I guess another thing, the Well of Dragons, will players need to complete a certain portion of the campaign? Dragons.
At the moment, no. We are discussing whether or not we need restrictions on getting into the Well of Dragons, but right now, on preview, as long as you have, I believe, 10,000 gear score.
Okay,
you can,
nice.
Get a quest from Nox, and he'll let you right in.
Oh, fantastic!
So once we get a little more testing on it and see what players are thinking, how well they're going through it, and you know what they want out of it, we'll probably start readjusting those numbers.
Very cool. I'm being back end. If you'll just excuse me for a moment.
I'm super happy so many people came out for this, helping us out, making this making this fight where we can see how well y'all are playing and how much y'all are liking it, making it better. Like I said, we're definitely working on performance. We're going to work on, you know, difficulty and just try to make this, you know, the most fun fight that you can have in Neverwinter from this next module. Everybody should slash dance. Enough, everybody might get booted out of this map, but we'll see what happens. Yeah, definitely, please leave your feedback on our forums about the Tiamat, the Rise of Tiamat encounter. I look at that every day. I take everything said there very seriously. We're trying to make this fight for you, so we'll have a great time with it. Definitely visit the forums, leave us all the feedback you can. Let us know what you think, what's fair, what seems unfair. Suggestions. We've got time to make this better. So.
I am back. Yeah, sorry about that, folks. But I come back bearing good news. So we actually have an additional... So first off, we're going to have our drawing for the Dragonborn pack. But I've also been informed that we have an additional attack wing starter set to give out. So we're going to give away. We're going to have a lightning round, and so I think we can use the same code word for both, just to save time, since you all have been so cool in entering Toasty Mott into. My lame attempt at a pun into chat. So let's find out who won. First, this is for the Dragonborn Legend Pack. Dardzel! Congratulations, Dardzel! You have won a Dragonborn Legend Pack. You, sir, Dardzel, you too can be a Dragonborn Legend. Much like my wonderful warlock, shown here, as a Soulbinder Warlock. Now, definitely get that set. Keep entering in a Toasty Mott, and we can give away our second Attack Wing Booster Pack. Excuse me, Starter Pack. So used to saying Scourge Warlock Booster Pack, but it's an Attack Wing Starter Pack. So definitely get excited, get that code word in there. And we've actually. We're actually nearing the end of the live stream. I guess are there any parting words you want to give us? Any hints, any tips, any tricks on sending Tiamat back to where she belongs?
Well, once the this goes live and people are able to fight Tiamat, there will be extra mechanics in the zone in the Well of Dragons that players will be introduced to that will make this fight better, easier for them. It'll get better rewards. So, just ready for that, and like I'm gonna make it a little harder for y'all, so
yeah,
you're gonna need it.
Crank up the dragon juice. All right, folks, you've been super patient. It's time to give away our second attack wing starter set, and that winner and that lucky individual who will be the talk of the town and the envy of all their friends is Turbo KV. Turbo KKV. It's that set extra K that makes the difference. So we've had a lot of fun today. We've answered a lot of questions, and we took down Tiamat. I'd say, all in all, a productive live stream. And You all can look for this, sometime after Module 5's release, which is in 13 days, I believe. I've been counting, marking it off on my calendar. And get happy, folks. Some other cool things coming your way, with some other Neverwinter related things. So this Saturday, so those of you who are in the Bay Area, this Saturday we'll be holding a live event at Gamescape in San Francisco. The details on it have been posted on our Facebook, and we're going to post it again just in case you missed it. But we're very excited because we get to hang out and talk about Neverwinter, play a little D&D, and so it's all in good fun. So if you find yourself in San Francisco or in just the San Francisco Bay Area, definitely consider making the trip to come out, because I'll be there, and I think Strum will be there, and I think Dwight might make an appearance. So hopefully if any one of our wonderful and talented development or QA team happens to come by, that's great too. So yeah, all right. And I believe we've reached the end of the stream. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
It's been a lot of fun. We had a blast, and thank you for all you do on Neverwinter, and for donating your time to be here today with us and answer some questions. And so on behalf of the Neverwinter community, we thank you for your hard work and your time.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for watching, and all the ones that participated in the fight. Thank you for just playing, and hope you had a good time.
Absolutely. Alrighty. Alright, take care, folks, and may your 20s always be natural. Alright, take care.